What's good? DJ Ricky Ricardo coming at you again today. What's good, peoples? It's been a minute. So guess what? Today, we're going to focus on that Marvin Gaye beat still. And this time we're going to focus on, like, if you hear the Mercy Mercy Me song, if you got really good ears, you can hear that they got, there's a Congo section in there. Like, there's like a drum section, a Congo drum section in there, if you listen real good. And also, when you hear the snare hits, when you hear the snare, it sounds like there's like another instrument hitting at the same time that gives an effect. I can't really describe the sound of the effect, but you'll see. I'm gonna give you a demonstration of what I'm talking about.
All right, people. So yes, we got the song loaded up inside of the DAW. So this is what the song looks like when I get it inside of my my DAW. If y'all don't know what that means, I don't know what to tell y'all. Y'all shouldn't be a musician. But anyway, so we got the song loaded up, and I'm zooming in, and let's play it. So I'm gonna show you what I'm talking about.
You could actually see it. Sorry, let me go back. Let me rewind it. You hear the snare? You hear it goes. You hear it? So basically, I found out all that is just some Congo drums, a cowbell, the snare, and an old 1960s reverb effect. Now, this type of reverb, now it uses springs to get that certain effect that's in the song. In order to get that effect, you gotta get a spring reverb. Now, a spring reverb looks like this joint right over here. Now, give me a second. Sheesh. So these are spring reverbs, right? You could only achieve that effect by getting a real spring reverb. Like, software cannot duplicate the same sound as what these spring reverbs produce. Right? I mean, there was some software that tried to mimic it, but there's nothing that you're not gonna achieve that real sounding sound quality unless you got a spring reverb. All right. So basically, in the song, what they did was they used one of these, right? They ran the instruments or whatever. They ran their Congo drums, the snare, and the cowbell through this reverb to get that nice hall effect, you know. So in this video, we're gonna make the Congo drums a little bit different. We don't want the same beat, we don't want the same pattern as how it is in the song. So I'm gonna go through the song and I'm gonna show you how we're gonna change up the Congos and make the effect sound a little different. Peace. Alright, so how y'all doing? Oh yeah, I forgot to show y'all. I forgot to tell y'all. Yo, I wanted to show y'all this, since we're talking about congos and percussion instruments that we're gonna deal with in this video, I wanted to show y'all what I was gonna work with today. Oh wow, this is the virtual instrument that we're gonna work with today. It's called Cuba Discovery Series. Now, this joint is tough, bro. This shit got African drums, Cuban drums, and I'm talking about congos, percussion. I'm talking about a big-ass library of just a collection of just wonderful, wonderful sounds. You know, I want to big up our Native Instruments and Contact for making these nice products, for making us try out on YouTube. So, So let's get into it. I like this. So I check it. People, so here we go. So what I did was I transferred my Congos from my Mac to my Windows. You know, give me 1 second. Yeah, so I transferred the sounds from my Cuba Conga and I sent it to my Windows, which is over here, and now I brought it up into Edison on this free loop. So what I did was I already took this out and I made 2 drums. Alright, so I got them out, I took them out of there, and I placed them in the mix. And so this is what it sounds like. Not done yet, but it still needs some more volume and it still needs some more work. But when it's complete, I have a feeling y'all gonna like this shit. Alright, so catch me in the next video, feel me? Peace. Yo, what's good? It's DJ Rick Ricardo in the building. Yeah, man, we back to making this Marvin Gaye beat again. So this time where we left off, we put some Congo drums in. I showed you the new instrument that I was using, the Congo, what's it called again? The Cuba percussion. That shit's fire. Today, I wanted to, I forgot to announce. On December 6th, I'm gonna be releasing my new cover instrumental I did from the Jacksons, and I think it's pretty sick. You guys might like it, and so check that out when you got some time. But back to what we were talking about. My computer was cracking up because I had too much instruments playing at the same time. So when that shit happens, it kind of like messes up your computer. It slows everything down. So what I had to do was I had to take my the organ that we made from the last video, and I had to turn it into a WAV file. As you can see, I'm holding it right here. I've had to turn it into a WAV file and put it in my my playlist. I couldn't have the instrument open because it was crashing the song, and the song wouldn't even play. So basically, I just laid down the organ right here in the red. You can see right here. Let's play it. We're just gonna solo the organs. Excuse me. You hear that? See, that happens a lot. So I had to reduce the memory. So in order to reduce the memory, you just use your Edison, right? Record the instruments from there and then take the file and put it inside of your pattern or whatever you call it, and then you can erase the VST and it'll save memory for you. So basically, I was talking through the whole thing. Listen to it. That sounds sweet. That's just the organs and the congos that we did earlier. Yeah.